Who gives this bride the biscuit?
Paige gives herself with the blessing and love of her family.
All right, friends and family, thank you very much for being on here on this hot and happy day. I'd like us all to take a moment and recognize those who can't be with us and those who can't walk with us. Go ahead and be seated. So quick words. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. Does not boast. And is not proud. At this time, I believe Aaron has a few words to say.
This is a stanza by Christopher Poindexter. Whenever I am away from you, the distance between us, a burdensome thing, I always think of you in colors, the smell of coffee as you so proudly make it for me, the perfect sunlight spilling in through the window. I miss you even when you are beside me. I dream of your body even when you are sleeping in my arms. The words "I love you" could never be enough. I suppose we'll have to invent new ones.
All right. Hi, Lord. I am so delighted to be standing here with you today. I am honored to share my love for you in front of our closest friends and family. I liked you instantly, and our love was inevitable. You came into my life at a time when I felt very lost. At 19 years old, I did not know who I was, and everything felt messy and challenging. When we met, it felt like catching my breath for a long time after struggling to breathe. I can't really tell you the moment in which I knew you were the one for me, because from that very first night together, being with you has always felt right. Thank you for walking me home all those years ago. I'm not lost anymore, and I'm more sure of myself today than I ever have been. Every part of me loves you. Thank you for your kindness, your strength, your humor, and your faith in this love that we share. Thank you for supporting me through mental health challenges and sobriety. Thank you for always looking for new ways for us to have fun together, whether that's playing games, watching movies, or just jamming to some music. Thank you for lazy Sundays with our favorite cookie. And most of all, thank you for teaching me how to love myself. My love, above all things, I promise to be your friend. I promise to love you in every way that I can. I promise to put this love above all else, because we are a team in this big, messy life, and we always will be. I promise to respect, to listen, to try and understand. I promise to remind you who you are, and to show you that you are worthy and lovable. I promise to be the best version of myself as often as I can be, because that's what you deserve. You're better at loving me than anyone else. Standing across from you in this moment, I know that I will be safe, happy, and loved for the rest of my life. I promise to return the favor.
All right, you ready? There you go.
First officially met you, July 3rd, 2014. I thought you were somebody who was alone. And I'm so thankful today that you took the courage over the next 3 months to finally strike up a conversation with the next third party.
For the nearly 9 years since, you have been my best friend, my biggest supporter, and greatest source of joy in my life. I admire so many of your qualities and continue to discover more each day. I truly believe you are the most caring person that I know. I am inspired by your strength and the way that you respond courageously to life's challenges. I love your sense of humor. Cannot recall a day that we haven't laughed together. I love that you love all of you. My quirks, my flaws, my neurodivergent traits, and my weird music are holding. You are beautiful inside and out, and I thank you with all of my heart for choosing you. As your husband, I promise to love you deeply as we continue our journey together as partners and humans. As we grow, I will love each version of you as strongly as I have this version and all of the others I've had the privilege of knowing. I will share in your dreams, support you in your goals. I will hold you in good times, and I will hold you closer in times that are less good. I will respect, honor, trust you. I will show my love for you with my actions and with my words each day. Whatever adversity life throws your way, you will not face it alone for all of my days.
All right. You have tokens to exchange?
We do.
Nolan, would you like to come up? After me. With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
May our days be ever better together.
May our days be ever better together.
This ring, I do wed.
This ring, I do wed.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
May our days be ever better together.
May our days be ever better together.
Do you, Tyler, take Paige to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Do you, Paige, take Tyler to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
Fantastic. I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride. I don't need the book anymore. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the privilege to present and cry Mr. and Mrs. Paige Scott and Tyler Scott. All right, ladies and gentlemen, before we adjourn to the air-conditioned comfort, we're going to meet...
Try not to.
Thank you. beautiful smiles up here towards me. So obviously this will be a group photo. I can meet you all. So I'm gonna count you off here just one set. All right, 1, 2, 3, best smile. Awesome. And because it looks better for video and we can do a celebration, right? 1, 2, 3. I'm counting you this time. Let's see some hearts. Woo! Right? I give it 1, 2, 3. Woo!
No. You can try to catch the bouquet.
Oh,
any of you. I'm just gonna throw it.
Whip it.
I am. I've never done this before.
so proud of you guys. Kristen, I love you guys so much. We're excited to spend more time with you this year as camping is coming up. And you look fabulous. Just brought tears to my eyes when you came down the aisle, girls. Congratulations.
Showing up and nice enough guy, very soft spoken, kind of kept to himself, which is fine. And he kept coming around year after year after year. Just had a very nice smile, hanging out, pleasant company. And then several of us get together and do a camping trip, a group camping trip once a year. And I remember the one time, it was only a few years ago, when it was some guy showed up with a big scary dog and wanted to know where his people were at our campsite. And so whenever we guys in the group kind of have this thing when something, there's an intruder potential or something like that, we step up, kind of stand up there in line and I know what's going on. So we did that at that time and I looked over to my side and there was Tyler right next to me, just ready. And I was like, okay. Literally, at this point, if you know me, this is where I like to make a toast, but that's not my job tonight. Other people have that job, and so let's get started with the first one. The first one is Mr. Bump. He also goes by Calvin, but you can call him Bumpy.
I haven't given a speech since Keller and I were in high school. I want to keep this short and sweet because everyone here tonight already knows how special these people are. And want to get on to the celebration for everyone. Firstly, I want to thank Tyler for choosing me to be his best man. It truly means the world to me to stand by his side on this special day. I can't express how much of an immense honor it is, and I'll probably never forget the day he called to ask me to be his best man. I could hear in the tone of his voice that he had something important he wanted to ask me, and he's usually, anytime he gives me a call, he's usually kind of silly, so I could tell it was a big deal he wanted to ask me something. He sounded a little anxious at first, and I was a little anxious at first because I didn't know what the hell he was going to ask me. But by the end of that call, he had me tearing up because it just meant so much to me to be asked that. I was so appreciative and proud that he thought highly enough of me to fill the role for him. So thank you, dude, for that. I've known Tyler for about 20 years, which felt insane to me to think about as I was writing this. And honestly, I can say he's one of the most genuine, intelligent, funny, and caring people I've ever met. As my group of friends has changed, as I've gotten older, Tyler's been one of the few constants of those people. He's always been such an incredible friend to me. He's always been there for me, and I know he has and always will be there for Paige too. Tyler introduced me to Paige for the first time at a Halloween party about 10 years ago now, which I think. With the time that I spent with Paige, I can really see why they're meant to be. You're both so funny and kind, and I'm sure as everyone here knows, it's such a joy to spend time with you guys. I've seen how Tyler lights up when he's with you, Paige, and it's clear that you both bring out the best in each other. So let's raise a glass for Tyler and Paige. May your journey together be filled with endless love and happiness that you both bring to the world. Cheers. Cheers. Love you guys.
Okay, the next toaster was also a child at the time, and Shane and I first got to know her, but she was hanging around, in Paige's house a lot, and she was also a very nice young person who also liked adults, coincidentally, and I'd like to introduce her now, the maid of honor, Jessica.
Bald-headed, chubby baby, which is about 26 years now, which is also really crazy to think about when I was writing this. It's a long time. When I think about growing up and becoming who I am, I think about Paige a lot and how influential that you have been in my life. Our age gap is not very big, but when I was younger, it felt much, much bigger to me. And I looked up to Paige as a role model very intensely. I don't know if you know that. You were so brave and outgoing, bold, and so funny. Things that I wasn't as a kid. You made me feel comfortable and confident and helped me break out of my shell. You taught me to be authentic and to not care what other people thought. You were unstoppable in my eyes. I just remember you with ease being able to jump into that freezing cold swimming pool while I would stand frozen in fear for what probably felt to Paige like an eternity. So you're just waiting there eagerly for me to play mermaids with you or something. She got a bee sting waiting to get jump into the pool once. It was really bad. But all in all, you taught me to dive headfirst into things that scared me and didn't just stop at swimming pools. You are truly like a big sister to me, and you taught me to be unstoppable just like you. Although a lot has changed since we were kids, you are still that bold, beautiful, spirited, and even more funny kid that I knew when we were growing up. You were just so extremely influential to me. You mean the world to me. You're the best sister that I could ever ask for. You always knew what to say when I needed you, always there for me. I only wish to be able to do that for you. And no one deserves you more than Tyler. Tyler, the way that you cherish Paige and support her is just heartwarming, and I could not ask for a better partner for my sister. I love you both so much, and I'm so happy that you have each other. I'm excited to add you to my family and to get ready, because you're adding not one, not two, but three more sisters to your family. I love you both so much, and I'm just so happy to be here with you celebrating. So please raise a glass for Paige and Tyler Scott.
Cheers!
Cheers!
Cheers.
Thank you, Jessica. Okay, next up, the mother of the bride, one of the matriarchs of our community, and one of my favorite people.
I'll try to
question about this beautiful day, and your vows were amazing. And it's nice that Paige has found someone who appreciates how amazing she is and who deserves her. Let's see. I'm grateful so many people were here today to celebrate and witness this big commitment you've made to each other. In the years you've been together, I've watched you, how you've grown, how you both have grown together and strengthened your relationship. You've supported each other through significant life challenges, and most importantly, you always make time to celebrate the good things together, which is very important, especially your love for each other. You definitely have a strong foundation for a successful marriage. I'm so proud of both of you. I love you both. I'm glad to have you in my family, Tyler. Thank you for loving my girl.
Okay, thank you, Naomi. Okay, next up is Naomi's partner and my confidant and personal butler, Dave.
So the kids asked me to say a few words. Well, Naomi told me the kids asked me to say a few words, and I'm like, really? The kids came over a couple days, and I'm like, do you really want me to talk? Most people that I know have a fear of public speaking, and most people that know me have a fear of me speaking. So I'm like, how long do you want me to go? And they're like, oh, the whole thing's like 15 minutes. I'm like, oh. So I threw away the PowerPoint and the three notes, pages of notes. So I just have them short. And I wrote note cards, so I can keep track.
Here we go.
You're good, man. All right, so I have two new kids now, and I was thinking, okay, what can I teach these kids about life, the universe, and everything? Love and relationships, and realized you've taught me more than I could ever teach you. You guys have grown so well together, so much, so strong. I hope I can teach you at least something, because this relationship is strong as rock. So, congratulations, good luck, God bless, and may the odds be ever in your favor.
Let me add another note, that Tyler's uncle, he is not here. He didn't know. He was going to officiate the wedding. He tested positive for COVID. It's like a good citizen, he stayed home, which created a situation where they had to find somebody else to do the service, and David was the one who was qualified and stepped up to do it and had a beautiful service. And another note, Tyler's mother, Eva, also tested positive.
Oh, no.
You saw her and heard Kim speak about her at the end of the ceremony. So she is not here, is that right?
Right.
I assume
that
she is not.
I do have a speech.
You got it, oh yes. And therefore, our last toaster, please welcome, great guy, just been at this weekend. How are you, one of my favorite people? Tyler's dad.
Yeah. Kim.
Thank you for your support, as well as the support of those who could not be here tonight, sadly, including me. As well as those who are no longer with us on this earth, but live in our hearts. I remember when we came to tour this venue, There was a rather proper older gentleman, the owner of Ainsworth at the time, Kevin. He spoke with a bit of an English accent and had a reserved and pleasant sense of humor. I remember him saying, long after people have forgotten what the colors of the napkins were or the type of flowers, they will remember what was said. And I thought, how very insightful. Then I thought, oh my God, what am I going to say? It will be remembered forever. So I struggled with that impactful thing I could say. I struggled for quite some time. Then I did what I often do. I relied on my own personal experience, so I thought about it. I thought about what was said my way. I didn't remember a single thing. Said my way. I was just so happy to be getting married. Well, that's pretty cool. Sorry, Mom. I do remember feeling very loved and supported. I just don't remember specifics of what was said. With the pressure off, it gave me space to think about the things that I observed and appreciated about your relationship over these last 9 years. Some I noticed occasionally, some consistently. Things like kindness, supporting one another during difficult times, comfort when grieving, standing up for each other, finding new interests that you both enjoy, saying yes when it was not your first choice, saying no when it was important to do so. Growth and maturity. May these things that nurture a relationship and many more continue to grow. So toast to Tyler Page, lift your glass. May you continue to grow a wonderful life together. So, I'm going to be really quick. I just want to say, I love these two. First off, they were Ram fans. So that should tell you about their ability to stay through the good and bad again. They have been through it all. But what I really want to say is, thank you for loving each other. And it sounds quite as tough. But love really does, it's what we need in the world right now. Love brings us together. Just look around the room. There's probably differences in politics, differences in all kinds of things, right? We can focus on those. But what we build is family, we build community. We build that through love. And this is just an extension of that. And to me, that is a remarkable thing. And I'm just so proud to be in family with you. Our new family, new friends, old family, old friends. Thank you so much for being here. It's a world to me.
Thanks so much, Kim. It's been a pleasure meeting you. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the opening act. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the main act. Paige and Tyler Scott.
Foremost, we would like to thank all of you for your presence here today and our special moment. Everyone in this room has supported us over the years and will continue to do so. We cannot thank you enough for that. We would like to recognize those who have traveled to be here with us today, some from as far as Taiwan.
Yeah.
We are honored that you made the trip.
Thank you to all of the staff here at Ainsworth House and Gardens for hosting and coordinating our special day. Thank you, Chef Keith, and the team at Your Kitchen Chef for providing such a wonderful meal for our guests. Cam Ray and Steven, Thank you so much for capturing this event and pictures and video to be enjoyed over the years to come.
A special thank you to all of you who helped make this day possible. Aaron, thank you for your lovely poetry reading to kick off our ceremony. Thank you to our wonderful flower girls and rain bearer. Kat, Faith, Ellery, and Nolan, we love and appreciate you all. Tim, thank you for lending your voice and keeping us organized this evening. Mom. There are no words to express how grateful we are for all of your contributions and support throughout this experience. We couldn't have done this without you, and we love you so much. Jessica, my chosen sister, I'm so lucky to have had you by my side through this adventure. I love that preparing for this day has allowed us to spend so much time together. I can't wait to get matching tattoos.
Yeah!
It would be impossible to adequately thank the next few people without acknowledging the unfortunate impact COVID has had on our plans here today. For those that haven't met them, the lovely couple in the field, my dad's still here, with a guitar and a KN95s are my wonderful parents, Kim and Eva. When my dad called me yesterday with the news that some key players would be out sick today, he was seriously considering playing his guitar and then coming up to officiate the ceremony himself, if need be. I feel like that tells you all you need to know about this guy's dedication and steadfast support of us. Mom, your contributions, hard work, and love can be seen and felt in too many facets of this celebration to list. Thank you for helping to make this such a wonderful evening. That you will dance with my sunburned ass when I return to the My uncle, Reverend Shane, was unable to officiate today due to COVID, but I know he would want me to tell you all to check him out on Spotify. That's Reverend Shane. David, thank you for stepping up and officiating a wedding on one day's notice. You had big shoes to fill, literally, and you did amazing.
Yeah.
Bumpy. Somehow. Thank you for being my best man and such a great friend. Thanks for hanging out, driving, and being such great company throughout this process. It's been awesome to spend this time together with you.
Absolutely, man.
In closing, our only ask of you is to eat cake, dance, and be your wonderful selves to help us kick off this wedding in style.
Yeah.
Okay, take a moment to talk amongst yourselves. We are going to be relocating to the cake table at your convenience. Thank you.
Thank you. Tomorrow I'll bet that you and I will walk together again. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.